Rocco, I'm number 20. I'm a junior and I'm a guard.
Alexa Holland, junior guard, number 10.
Ali Larkin, junior guard, number 30.
Bailey Abbott, senior forward, number 24.
Hi, I'm Keaton Stasia. I'm a junior and I'm a forward, number 12.
Grace Pfeiffer, freshman guard, number 14.
Alexis Elliott, freshman guard, number 22.
Kennedy Moseman, freshman center, 44.
Morgan Ruff, freshman guard, number 32.
I'm Alexa Garrison, number 40, and a sophomore forward.
Emma Dahlquist, freshman center, number 54.
At one guard will be a 5'4 senior, Crystal Steller. The second guard, a 5'6 senior, Becca Kennedy. At the third guard will be a 5'4 senior, Kylie Mason. At one forward will be a 5'10 senior, Lauren Hostrosser. And at the center position, a 5'9 junior, Jayla Meister. Practice coach by Mr. Andy Heckman. For the Rochester Lady Zebras, they are 9-0 this week and ranked 8 in Class 3A.
10-0.
10-0? Did I miss a game?
Yeah, last Saturday.
Rochester Lady Zebras 10-0 and ranked 8 this week, Class 3A bowl. At one guard will be a 5'3 junior, Alexa Holland. The second guard, 5'4 junior, Becky Malco. The third guard, 5'6 junior, Allie Larkin. At one forward, 5'4 junior, Keaton Stasiak. And the other forward, 5'8 senior, Bailey Abbott. Rochester coach for Mr. Tony Stasiak. You know, it's kind of neat. Don't see this kind of introduction anymore in high school sports.
Yeah.
And the lights are off. It kind of reminds you of the bowls of way of the day. Probably when you were like one or two.
Last time I saw this was Warsaw High School when Dad was coaching, and could not believe it. But yeah, this is cool.
Spotlight is on, lights are off, and each girl coming off the bench and starting gets the spotlight on her at half court. So we are ready for varsity action against 7-3 Triton and 10-0. Rochester, Rat Thomas, Abby Malco, I'm David Musselman. The JV game tonight, man.
Just talking about that.
Next action for the Lady Zebras will be Saturday morning, as they will throw it up at North Miami at 11. JV just woke to the JV or varsity start at North Miami High School just Friday night. The guys are back in action after about a 2-week layoff,
right,
as they get back to conference play as well.
North Miami as well, you said?
Yes, North Miami Friday for the guys, North Miami girls on Saturday.
And Lewis Cass Friday night for the boys. Saturday night for the boys.
Yeah?
Yep, I think it's a double weekend. That's
what
I'm saying in the
morning. Wow. Busy. No. Lewis Cass is on the 30th this year.
Sure.
So the tip is up and controlled by the Triton Lady Trojans. Stellar. Rochester, 2-2-1 trapping defense. And then Triton loses the basketball out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by Rochester on that far side right at the timeline. Boy, they're going to get after it right now.
Yeah, they are. Well, yeah, more turnovers you force if you can get into a scoring position quickly.
Yeah.
That's where you'll gain an advantage.
Sellers.
And Triton's going to need the reversal if they're going to make it across half court.
You're right. Post crosser to Kennedy.
Now they kind of fall back into a 1-3-1 zone due to Lady Z.
Pass the tip to Kennedy. Now pass over the top of the tip. But Kennedy has it on the right wing. Pull up tip center off the right side. It's no good. And the offensive rebound actually is dipped out of bounds by the offense. It'll go to Rochester.
And that's where Rochester's going to have to be productive, is on that off or defensive rebound. If they can limit Triton to one shot and done, they don't score a lot to begin with. And if you can take away opportunities, again, gain an advantage.
Would you say this is a 3-2 or it looks like to me a 1-2-2 for Triton defense?
Yeah, I would say 1-2-2.
Stasiak, top of the key, bounce pass behind the right side of Larkin. One bounce pass, top of the key, now to Holland. Back to Larkin, right wing. Allie to Malco. Becky drives it to the elbow, cut off from the double team, out to Holland. Well, to the three and drive.
That's what that zone does, the 1-2-2. It takes away that dribble drive penetration that makes it really difficult.
Becky Malco turns the ball over, stolen by Triton, quickly up the floor, the Lady Trojans. Monster's layup is no good, and the rebound to Malco. Becky runs over the floor, 1-on-3 break in favor of Triton. Malco's leaner's blocked. Triton picks up, and Mason runs the other way. Mason, make that light. Yeah, Mason outside right. And she goes to the baseline hard, and Keaton Stasiak's going to pick up a blocking foul, and it'll be out of bounds to Triton, baseline right.
But unfortunately, you hate to see anybody pick up a foul that quickly into the ball game, but, you know, it could have been either way, block or charge, and the defense usually, more times than not, picks that up.
Sellers to Kennedy, three, top of the key, no good. Rebound tipped around, and Bailey Abbott comes out of there with it, gives to Malco. Rochester runs to our right, Becky to the center circle. Now the right wing. Right elbow, bounce past the corner to Larkin. Larkin on the wing, picks up the dribble in the baseline to Malco.
You notice they're coming all the way out, putting pressure on those three-point shooters.
Yep.
Nobody's really had an open look yet.
Well, that's our game. Everybody knows that's our game.
Absolutely.
Dribble penetration in the three, and there are no seams right now.
Holland backs down to the volleyball line and resets for Rochester. Now to Malco high on the right side. Becky holds, couple of dribbles behind the three-point line to Larkin. Back to Malco, right side to X. Quick three, Thomas Keith, Lady Beavers is good.
Alexa Holland found about 6 inches of free space.
Quick release by X.
Three-pointer for Rochester. Meister goes to basket hard. She throws up a shot. It's in. And now it's 3-2 Rochester. 5:45 to play in the first quarter. Now we're going to have an official timeout.
Untied shoe. Well, the guard trio for Lady Zebras, Larkin, Holland, and Malco, I think, again, just like they did Saturday against Wabash, they're going to have to work in conjunction with each other and move that ball quickly around that zone to find the opening.
Quick reversals and patience.
Right.
Travels are only going to result in very bad news for the Zebras.
Did you just learn how to tie your shoes today?
You know what? She's new shoes, but I'm making no excuses for her.
Right in the zone. It looks like to me a 1-2-2 zone. Larkin, left side to Malco, dumb down low to Abbott. Abbott gets the triple team out to Larkin, three, left wing, short, rebound tipped around, and Frank comes out of there with it. Mason, right wing behind the three-point line, hesitates, now accelerates to the baseline, wraps around the head to the baseline before she does that, she steps out of bounds, got to go back to Rochester.
And that, if the Lady Zebras were paying attention, the inside out was Keaton running the middle because they're in their five offense right now. Went down low, and they all crashed hard on Bailey back up. And that's the only way they're going to get an open shot.
Bailey was looking at a quadruple team.
Yeah.
Now go top of key. The Holland makes the three. Drives it right. Goes to the basket. Layup on the way. No good. The bounce thing on Meister. That's going to send X to the line to shoot two.
You know, as good as X is doing, making that move and getting to the basket, I really wish she'd a little more concentration to finish it.
Yes.
So Holland at the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras. Up 3-2. X eyes it. Flies it. Nope. Drop one more. That one just a buzz short.
But hard dribble penetration by X. And
yeah.
Triton just, girls just stood there.
Second one for the juniors. Good this time. 4-2 Rochester. 5-11 to play in the first quarter.
I think that's what Lexi does, or Alexa does very well.
Yes.
Create opportunities
Absolutely.
For herself.
Yep.
Find an opening.
I think the girls are finding out this is not going to be a very slow-paced game.
Triton with the basketball breaks the press. Gets it around the trap. To Meister, to Kennedy, down to the key to Sellers, left side to Mason.
Lady Trojans are moving that basketball very quickly.
Yes.
Sellers goes to the basket hard, kind of out of control. She picks up a foul. The shot should go to the line to shoot two.
The foul is going to come against Abbott, her first, team second. Yeah, I think Triton's doing a great job of moving that ball from corner to corner around the top.
Oh, yeah, over the top, that's right.
And driving when they see a lane.
Free throw by Sellers is good. She'll have one more. Looking to tie this game at four with 4:49 to play in the first quarter. Matt Thomas, Abby Malcolm, David Musselman. Sellers at the line for one more. She eyes it, flies it. It's good. We're tied at four. So much for a 72% free throw shooter, huh, Brad?
Yeah. Well, the team, they only shoot 50%. So,
yeah. He shoots 72.
Mason does.
Becky got away with the carry. She's in the lane, kicks it out to Holland. X on the baseline, goes up hard over Meister. Short. Rebound to Hoostrosser. She has a stolen by Holland. She kicks it out. Stasiak gives to Larkin in the corner to X. Makes a three. Back to Larkin, top of the key, right side to X. Got Larkin, left side to Malco. One dribble, out to Holland. Looks at a three straight away. Now backs it out of the left wing and resets for Rochester. 4-4, first quarter. Malco in the lane, down low to Abbott. Layup is good.
Good job by both Malco and Abbott. I think that's what Becky does really, really well. The dribble penetration draws the defense up, and then she's able to find the open player down low on the block.
Yep.
Meister gets around Bailey. Adams throws the shot up. No good. Put back is good.
And the rebound jumping is not going to work for Lady Zebras. They need to box out.
Yeah, boy. You're
right.
Away from the basket.
Mm-hmm.
Tied at six. Holland high on the left side. 3:50 to play first quarter. Now to Malco between the rings. Becky back to Holland left side. Next a couple of dribbles. Back to Malco. At the elbow, the X, the Larkin, three from the baseline. Way off the mark, picked up by Kennedy. Triton runs to my left. Now to Sellers, through the center circle. We're tied at six. Baseline to Meister, outside to Mason. She'll fire a three. It's short. Rebound to Holland. Rochester runs. We're tied at six. Holland right in front of the floor. Hesitates. In the corner to Larkin. Alley back to Holland on the right wing, looks at a three, passes it up, gives it to Malco in the paint, and she has a pass stolen and taken away by Mason. Mason will go in for the right-handed layup. It's off the window and good, and it's 8-6 Triton.
Becky trying to again pass that down to Abbott. This time Triton able to close on the passing lane and take it away.
I think that when Becky gets in there, she's just going to have to rise up and shoot it.
Yep. She probably will a couple of times to make sure that defense draws up on her, create those passing lanes.
Morgan Ruff will come into the next dead ball as Markman has it. Down low to Abbott. Abbott has her pass stolen by Zellers. Zellers for Triton, left side of the floor, will go in. It's no good, but a foul coming on Malco, who dipped her a little bit. And that's going to send Zellers back to the line to shoot two.
And that's going to be something the Lady Zebras are going to have to get corrected right away. It's better pass lanes.
And she's going to foul to let her shoot.
That was always my motto.
Right on.
Make sure she misses if you foul her.
Harrison will come back into the game or come into the game for the first time for Rochester. Sellers has two. First on the way is good.
Yeah, you were right. She is about the only one on this Triton basketball team that shoots pretty decent from the free throw line.
I'll just foul somebody else
then. Yeah.
Abbott, Stasiak is out. In for the first game is Hannah Jennings for Triton. And Sellers at the free throw line for one more, looking to push their lead to four. 2:41 to play. In the first quarter, Triton up by four, as Sellers is 4-4 from the free throw line. Holland on the run, left side, Malco. Got a rough between the ring. Morgan, one dribble, bounce pass to Holland in the corner, quickly to Larkin. Back to Holland on the wing, inside the three-point line to Larkin. Larkin inside the three-point line to Malco. Malco in the paint, gives it to Holland. Her 15-foot around in.
You know, great shot by Holland, made that pass by Malco look good. I think I'd rather have the shot from Malco. From 3 feet.
Quickly, Kennedy on the other end. Shoots, no good. Garrison to the board and gives to Holland. 10-8, right. Rochester runs down by two. Holland right side to Ruff. Ruff in the corner to Malco. Three in the lead on the way. No good off the mark. And Sellers with the rebound.
And neither team staying much up for pressure. Everybody's getting back pretty quick when the other team has the ball.
Rochester knocks the pass out of bounds. They'll stay with Triton. Baseline left. 1:56 to play in the first quarter. Triton by two. Sellers will look to get it in. Sellers, study. Still looking. Bounce pass into Kennedy. Top of the key to Mason. Mason drives it right against Malco. Now back to back outside to Kennedy between the rings. Now the other side to Sellers. Rochester in his zone defense to Mason. She rises up in the lane. Her shot's good. 12-8. Brighton. 100 seconds to play in the first quarter. Malco loses the handle, but didn't travel. Gets the rough down the ring. Ruff bounce pass to Malco, right side to Holland. Quick three, right wing, got again.
Let Holland helping us out a lot tonight.
Nine for Holland here in the first quarter.
Close to all of them.
Yep.
12-11. Triton on top by one. Over the top of the defense, ball moves to Mason. Rochester in the zone defense to Sellers. Quickly this side to Kennedy. Quick three from the left wing is short. And she gets her own rebound. Nice job following the shot to Jennings. Outside and wide open, Mason. On the way, right wing, it's good.
Slow rotation, wide open.
Second, third opportunities will kill you.
Yep.
Right back by four. Up in the corner. Morgan around the defense. Now pass to Malco between the ring. Malco out to Holland. Holland in the corner to Larkin with 40 seconds. Larkin, she'll fire a three over the defense. It's good as it rattles in.
Marshall, her first basket of the game. She only had 1 point on Saturday against Walmart.
That might have been Mason's 1,000th point if you look over at the student section.
Uh-huh.
Really? They didn't stop the game?
Yeah, I don't know why they have time to say 1,000, but that's my guess.
28 seconds. Sellers in the lane. Pass outside to Kennedy with 20. Kennedy gives to Mason with 19. Mason holds. Now to pass to Sellers with 8:16. Sellers backs it out to the center circle with 13. Dribbles in the center circle with no pressure with 11. Now drives it right with 9. High on the right side. Now to Jennings with 8. To Kennedy with 5. In between the rings at 3. Now pass down to the Mason. And we're going to have a foul coming on Morgan Ruff. 1.5 seconds to play in the first quarter.
That's
as Mason lost her footing. And Ruff is going to be saddled with a foul.
That's a late call.
Meister back into the game. And coming out is Hostroffer. Sells the wicked triggers in. Right by one with 1.5 seconds to play in the first quarter. Sellers will look to get it in. Does go to whatever Meister. Her jumper short at the buzzer. After one, Brighton leads 17-14. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball on 82.1 WROI.
Are you tired of your internet speed slowing you down? Not a problem. Get connected at the speed of light over RTC's advanced fiber optic network. Work, surf, or play on the net faster than ever before. Choose from multiple residential or business packages with speeds so fast, it'll have you flying away. Already have RTC's Fiber Connect internet? Upgrade your package today. RTC. Local services, local support, and local investments.
Meet Bob and Stan. Both bought new TVs. Stan watches all the popular ringside live events, boxing, wrestling, and the big fight. Bob can't. Stan gets out-of-market sports packages of baseball, hockey, and basketball. Bob can't. Stan gets live concerts and the hottest Hollywood hits. What's the difference? Stan uses InDemand's pay-per-view for all the special events, sports programs, and the newest movie releases. So call RTC today and start your own pay-per-view experience.
Going to the second quarter here at Triton High School, the Lady Trojans leading 17-14. And as we start this second quarter, I believe, I'm not sure who starts. Will Rochester start with the ball? Going to our right. Regardless, it was a flurry of three-pointers there for a while.
Yeah, both teams strike 1-5 from the three-point line. Rochester 3-7.
And Holland with a big first quarter.
She had 9 for the Lady Zebras, 9 of their 14.
Yep.
I think that's part of, that might also be one of their problems. We're going to have to get some more people involved to try and get this defense spread open a little bit.
That quarter reminded me of, as Holland fires a 3. She knocked out the shot, no good, but an offensive rebound.
By Abbott.
Yep. Now Ruff loses the handle, ball loose on the floor, picked up by Triton, she travels. You know what that first quarter reminded me of? Triton did.
Okay. So turnover apiece.
It reminded me of the Claire Cromer show we saw on Saturday night.
Yeah, you're right, yep.
And Cromer's the only difference. That's the only way Wabash stayed in the game. Ruff's jumper splat, shot no good, and ball loose. Triton picks it up. Mason out of the basketball for the Lady Trojans going to our left. And they're up by 3 at 17-14.
Well, I think it's the Lady Zebras could do a better job defensively, shutting down the passing lanes and taking away the easier shots.
Meister goes in for the baseline. Shot no good. Ball knocked out of bounds by Rochester, and Triton going to keep possession. Again, Triton had another offensive opportunity.
Well, they got, first of all, they got the shot almost point blank and just put it too hard off the backboard, and then they almost got the rebound. It went off the Zebras. So, yeah, Rochester got to do a better job of limiting their opportunities.
Lady Zebras aren't going to out-jump for rebounds tonight.
Yep, you're right. Kennedy at the elbow, high off the glass, no good. Holland to the board. X runs to our right, down by 3. X on the wing, hesitates, accelerates, pulls it back outside, bounce past Stasiak. Keith at the elbow to Holland on the baseline. X loses her footing, picks up the dribble, loses it out of bounds. Last touch by Triton, and will stay with Rochester right in front of the Triton bench. Brad Thomas, Abby Malco, David Musselman.
This is the point where, you know, some of the frustration may start to seep in, and you just got to kind of calm yourself down and concentrate on what you're doing.
Malco for 3, top of the key. Nope. Rebound to Ruff. Morgan then has it taken from behind, but she's tied up with Sellers. It'll go to Triton.
And as fast as this game is moving, patience is also key, because this turnover is just going to happen if they run around like crazy.
I think Rochester going to throw a 3-2 at him as well. Or
1-2-2.
Is it a box and one?
Well, it looks like Becky's shadowing Mason. Yeah.
Yep, it is.
Going to take the leading scorer away and maybe the, you know, the ball distributor.
The Triton has the basketball going to our left. Sellers in the corner, dribbles to the wing, right side of the floor.
Is that a triangle on two with Keaton on Sellers?
That could be. Nope. I think it's a box one.
I agree.
Yep. Top of the key to Sellers. Sellers left side to Meister. Quickly to Kennedy. Kennedy almost traveled. Almost gets tied up. Now we're going to have a turnover. 6:09 to play first half. Right by 3 and 17-14.
Well, that was a much better defensive effort by the Lady Zebras. Maybe one of the best ones of the game so far.
I agree.
Well, you know, that box one worked on Saturday.
It sure did.
Holland to Malco. Malco stands on the wing. Bounce pass right at the feet of Bailey Abbott.
Oh, is that hit?
Yeah,
Mason kicked it.
Bailey kicked that. So back into the game is Allie Larkin and Becky Malco to come out. Under 6 to play in the first half. Now we're going to have another Lady Zebra tying her shoe.
Just those double knotted.
I'd be looking in the bag for some duct tape.
Well, what you use when you don't want to use any timeout. You need to blow, tie your shoe.
Yep.
Stasiak to Holland, to Larkin. Back to Holland, to Larkin. Three, right wing. In and out, no good. Rebound, fall four. And Holland comes out of there with it. Gives to Ruff. Morgan to the paint. Down low to Bailey Abbott. Outside to Holland. Just inside the arc. Her 18 footer is good.
That's all right with the team. He plays on fire tonight.
Absolutely.
17-16. You might see Trent go to a box and one here before long.
Double digits for Holland already.
Meister gives in the corner to Sellers. Sellers a couple of dribble behind the three-point line. Kennedy. Kennedy against Ruff. Right side to Mason. Quickly to Sellers. Oh, boy. She got away from the walk. To Kennedy. Meister. Meister travels. Good defense by Stasiak and Bailey Abbott. 5:15 to play first half. Rochester down by one.
If Lady Zebras can get something rolling offensively.
Yeah, well, she's standing over there.
You're right on the far side.
Number 10.
Well, I think if Larkin can get something started, he's going to throw it away.
Mason will go in for the right left-handed layup. It's no good, but an offensive rebound to Kennedy. Kennedy loses the ball, picked up by Bailey Abbott.
Uh-oh.
Abbott runs, or make that rough run, out to Holland. X behind the arc, left wing.
Just about to comment about the physicality of the game so
that
far.
That was pretty physical.
Yeah, that's right. Fans thinking there should have been a foul.
Ruff over top of the defense to Larkin. Drives the baseline, throws up a shot. It's no good, way off the mark. Mason picks up the rebound for Trice. It gives to Sellers. 4.5 to play first half. 17-16 strike. Mason three, wide open left wing is good.
Mason now with 10.
And Price backed up by 4, 20-16. Holland outside to Larkin. Alley drives the baseline, cut off by the double team, throws it, trying to throw over it, gets stolen away, knocked out of bounds by Triton. It'll stay with Rochester. Now go back into the game, and Holland will sit down. Coming into the game for the first time is Nicole Secret, a freshman for Triton. Falco baseline right, well, it's triggered in. Becky studies. Over the top of defense to Larkin. Larkin on the wing. Right side, crossover dribble to the free throw line to Ruff. Morgan back to Larkin, left side. Wide open three for Lady Zebras is good.
Larkin with her second three of the game.
20-19. Rochester down by one under four to play in the first half. Meister, the Secret, quickly right side to Sellers. Lob pass inside to Jennings. She loses the handle. Ball loose on the floor. We're going to have a tie-up. Rochester going to get it back. Nice job down low. Quick hands on the Lady Zebras. Forced that turnover.
Allie Larkin.
Those drops are back into the game, and Jennings will sit down. Brad Thomas, Abby Malcolm, Juan David Musselman. Non-conference action tonight here at Triton High School. Right now, Triton up 20-19. They've held the lead most of this first half. Ruff to Stasiak, middle of the floor, back to Ruff, in the corner to Malco. Becky drives the baseline. Gets away with the travel, but turns it over right in the hands of Mason.
Should have pulled up and shot.
Yep.
Mason picking away through traffic. Goes inside the three-point line on the right wing. Outside to Meister. Meister quickly to Seacrest to Jennings. High on the right side to Mason. Right with the basketball going to our left. Jennings, she'll fire at three. Makes that Sellers three is good. And just when Rochester has an opportunity here to take the lead, Trice comes up with a three-point play.
Rochester's going to have to start pulling that 2-3 zone further out towards the three-point line.
Yeah, that's dangerous, especially when you got 5'10", 6 foot down low.
Well, that's what Trice's saying. It's, we're going to beat you from the three-point arc unless you come out.
Abbott on the baseline is going to travel. Tough to work down there against the triple team.
Yeah.
And Rochester gives the ball back to Trice with 2:52 to play. In the first half, as Kennedy comes back out of the locker room and will come back into the game. Kennedy will replace Seacrest for Triton. 2:52 to play in the first half. Triton up by four, 23-19. And Mason across the timeline against Malco. To Sellers, to Meister, quickly to Kennedy, Kennedy on the right wing. To Sellers, stands behind the arc, bounce past top of the key to Mason, to Meister, quickly left side to Kennedy. Now little Hostrosser. Hostrosser jumper over Bailey Abbott to him.
You can see how they are visibly quicker with their passing and a lot
of crisp.
Lots of screens being set.
Right by six.
Rochester doing a lot of standing, waiting for their turn to get the basketball.
And now we're going to have a foul on Triton. I believe Knights are going to pick that foul up and will be out of bounds to Rochester baseline right. .218 to play first half.
Knights will pick up first second.
Holland will come back in the game. Casey Atkins sit down. Seacrest back in for Triton, and Meister will sit. 2:18 to play in the first half. Rochester down to 6. Rochester basketball baseline right. Larkin on the wing. Now between the circles. Left side to Holland. Next, Holtz. One dribble to Ruff, top of the key. Ruff at the volleyball line. Works to the right wing in Seacrest. Now in the paint. And she's going to be fouled before the shot by the freshman Seacrest. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester. Odell in the game for the first time. And Odell, Bailey Abbott, sits. 2:03 to play. First half, right now 25-19.
Well, you can tell Coach Stasiak's worried about everybody's leg. He's had just about everybody rotated in and out of here already.
Yeah. Ruff, hard to the basket, shot. Good one, a foul.
Nice job by the freshman Ruff.
A three-point play right here is exactly what the doctor ordered. With 1:57 to play in the first half. Rochester's cut the lead to 4, maybe even 3 with a three-beat.
A foul on Sellers, her first.
Mo, the freshman, it's barely draws iron, but Holland with the rebound. X dribbles away from the defense, now to Larkin between the rings, right side to Malco, back to Larkin, left side to Holland. Holland to Larkin at the volleyball line to Malco. Behind the wing, around the defense to Malco, checking the paint, rises, off the window, it's good.
That's what I like to
see.
That's
what we needed.
Rochester taking a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Sealer Basketball, 92.1 WROI. At Triton High School. Rochester within 2 now with 1:15 to play in the first half. They've got the basketball going to our right.
After a Triton miss.
Malco for the tie. Too hard off the back of the rim. And Triton with the rebound. Ostrother with the basketball. Now ahead to the freshman. First shot is blocked. Secret blocked out of bounds by Larkin. It will stay with Triton. 59 seconds to play in the first half. I think, Mavi, that Becky is chasing Mason. How much gas did she have left? She chased Cromer all over the place.
That's what I'm thinking as well, because I know she's dragging Saturday night after chasing Cromer.
Ostrother has her blocked out, blocked behind. Morgan Ruff puts up the rebound and run. Ruff middle of the floor with 48. Outside to Holland. Quick to the mouth on the left wing. Becky, one dribble down to Larkin. Larkin dribbles to the top of the key and reset for Rochester with 40.
Well, I didn't necessarily see Coach Stasiak tell him to pull it out, but that seems to be what they're going to do with their last shot.
Brad, I think they're gassed.
Yeah, I agree.
I think both teams, if you look at Triton, they're barely hanging on defense.
They play Friday, you're right. Larkin around the defense at 25. Picks up a dribble, now to Malcolm at 22. Becky dribbles at 21. To Holland at the free throw line, out to Larkin with 17. Allie outside to Holland with 15. Back to Larkin with 13. Larkin pulls it out with 12. Bounce pass to Malcolm with 10. Becky holds with 8. Becky dribbles out to the right with 7. Becky drives with 5. Around the defense, throws it away. Sellers, jumper, his buzzer is no good. At halftime, Triton leads 25-23. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball on 92.1 WROI.
First Federal Savings Bank is Rochester's only locally owned bank. Stop in today to start a new checking or savings account. Learn more about our online banking options or sign up for Go Green Checking. the checking account that pays you back every time you use your card. Stop in today to see why local banking is better banking. First Federal Savings Bank, serving Rochester and surrounding communities since 1966.
Are you tired of your internet speed slowing you down? Not a problem. Get connected at the speed of light over RTC's advanced fiber optic network. Work, surf, or play on the net faster than ever before. Choose from multiple residential or business packages with speeds so fast, it'll have you flying away. Already have RTC's Fiber Connect internet? Upgrade your package today. RTC. Local services, local support, and local investments.
One game to go before Christmas. Have you started Christmas shopping yet?
Oh, I'm done Christmas shopping.
Really?
Yeah, I'm on top of this. All the deals are before Thanksgiving.
No, I hear what you're saying. Did you go out to get those deals?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, Abby, I thought you were smarter than that.
No, I'm a girl. We enjoy shopping.
Kennedy hard to pass and right around the defense, and it goes in.
That's her first point.
I don't care what you are. You're fighting a mob scene out there.
Not on Black Friday. It's Wednesday before Black Friday.
Oh, yes. You cheated.
Yes, I'm not crazy.
Holland at the corner. Gives to Larkin. Back to Holland, right side. Holland, a couple of dribbles to Larkin. Back to X.
And I am seeing a little quicker step from the Lady Zebras offensively, and they are cutting and screening.
I tell you what, that 10-minute halftime is a big deal.
Yeah.
I'm sure they would have taken 15 if it was given to them.
I think so.
Stasiak drives the baseline, wraparound pass to Larkin. She'll fire a three from the wing. It's good as a rattle pin.
Larkin with her third pointer of this ballgame.
Rochester down by one at 27-26.
And there's the half-court trap.
Over the top of defense goes to Mason. Mason's pass deflected. Meister has it. And her pass deflected. Holland has it. Now we're going to have a foul coming over the top by Sellers. Is that going to be two on Sellers?
I think she kind of sat on it.
That is two on Sellers.
Well, we're not going to keep it a family affair at Indiana State, are we?
Nope. I'm like, wait, can't. She just leave it to X to be the oddball out.
Congratulations. That's pretty neat.
That is. Great job.
Going to Ohio, playing softball. Of course, Becky's going to Indiana State to play softball.
Probably won't play each other, but...
You know, you won't?
No, we don't play MAC schools usually.
Holland looks at a three and passes up. Boy, she wanted to pull the trigger on that. She could. Now Malcolm with the volleyball line. Becky has her pass kicked away by Mason, and it'll stay with Rochester underneath the basket baseline right. 6:26 to play. In the third quarter, Rochester down by one.
I would not be surprised if Coach Stasiak wants to try and get something in the paint so that'll open up the perimeter.
You're a genius. But that's exactly what happened. That pass got into the paint. Malco, she's fouled the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Shot
like you're in the huddle for crying out loud.
Taking notes, cheating, making notes, making yourself look smart.
Becky with two. First one is short.
Free throws aren't our friends tonight.
Legs aren't our friends tonight.
Legs and concentration, maybe, I don't know.
It's been a long time since Rochester's been tied with Triton. Becky has an opportunity to do that here. Second on the way for the junior. Looks better and is better. 27-27. 6:25 to play in the third quarter. Sellers over the top of the defense. The host roster outside to Kennedy. Kennedy on the right wing. Host roster at the free throw line. Driving against Stasiak outside to Kennedy. Kennedy holds behind the 3-point line. One dribble to her right, gives top to Sellers.
Right, doing the same with Host Holler, trying to take advantage of their height in the paint.
To Mason. Mason gets the triple team. Out to Kennedy, quickly to Meister, left side to Sellers. Sellers one dribble. To the volleyball line to Kennedy, no-look pass to Mason. In the right corner to Meister. Meister bounce pass to Sellers.
Sellers well, Lady Zebras can't lose their concentration as Triton keeps that possession moving.
Down low to Hostrosser. Hostrosser against the double team, the Meister. Right side to Mason. Mason drives it right. Gives down low to Hostrosser. Hostrosser gets Abbott. Shot no good, but a foul coming on Rochester.
Abbott's going to pick up her second. There wasn't a whole lot she could do once Hostmeister got the ball.
She kind of rolled on Bailey. Bailey was on her backside, yeah. Back-to-back against her.
You know what I'd like to see? I'd like to see Kennedy come in here and bang with Hostrosser.
At least keep her busy while they're chasing Mason around.
First one by the 5'6 senior is good. Back up are the Lady Trojans, the 28-27, and Bailey Abbott will come out with two fouls. Postross with one more right.
I'll guarantee you, if Postross starts getting more and more opportunities to score, he's going to have to.
Yeah.
He's going to have to.
She hits both. It's 29-27. Right back on top with 5.5 to play in third. Holland right wing, left side to Malco in the corner of the run. Morgan is fouled by Sellers. That's going to be foul number three. And for a team that doesn't go very deep into their bench, he's going to have to now.
That could be a big deal. Sellers was 7 points in that first half. She was kind of the offset to Mason.
Yep. And it's almost as if the refs took a halftime, too. They seem to be a little bit more than needed.
Yeah, a little tighter.
Yep.
Yeah, I agree. So Secret comes in. Forge right. Zone defense with Lady Trojans to Malco. Malco with the elbow. Out to Holland. Speed left wing. It's off the mark. No good. Stasiak with the rebound. Keaton in the paint. Foul before the shot. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester.
Good job by Stasiak to keep that ball alive. Foul coming against Meister. Her third.
So you get a freshman game tomorrow night?
Yes, I do. I think so.
I don't know. I think I'd like to hear you call that game.
I don't think anybody wants to hear that.
You got to practice.
They might lose business on the spot.
Larkin for three in the lead. It's good.
Larkin with her fourth three-pointer of the basketball game gives Rochester their first lead.
30-29. First lead in a long time. You're right.
I think that was her first ever.
Kennedy on the block. Carries the ball. Gets away with the travel. He picks it up. Gives her up. Morgan pushes for Rochester, up by one, through the center circle, middle of the floor, works right wing, down to Malco, right side to Holland, oh boy, couple of dribbles, pulls it out to the wing, gives to Ruff, Ruff holds, one dribble left side, now to Larkin, back to Ruff, so, to Holland, next to Morgan, works right side, and now Mason's going to pick up a cheap body foul. Yeah, good news.
Wow.
Out of bounds to Rochester on the far side.
So the Lady Trojans, two of their starters with three fouls, and Mason, the third starter, picking up her second.
And in defense of all the girls out there, it was not like this in the first half. They were bumping each other the whole time, so they're probably a little surprised by these calls.
That 15 foul would probably been nothing called in the first half.
Yep.
So that's all five of them.
That's starting to be a huge deal here for the Lady Trojans.
You're right. Holland to Malco, Becky. Fouled by Kennedy, no call. Gives him the corner to Stasiak for three on the baseline. Is off the mark, no good. Rebound sitting around, and then we're going to have an over-the-back call on Allie Larkin. Don't look at her like that. I'm all right with that shot.
So Larkin picks up her first.
Just because she has an F in her name doesn't mean she can't take that shot, right?
Hey, I think
the ball does not agree on her shooting.
Holland almost steals the inbound pass, now does. And now we're going to have she's got a bounce by Kennedy.
Oh,
no call.
Oh, wow.
They're going to call it. It'll go back to Triton.
The referee just shaking his head saying no push, no push. And that's unbelievable.
You can see the little hip thrust by Kennedy to push her out of bounds and no call. Triton will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Ladies Junior Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Minutes to play in the third. Rochester up 30-29, and the defense is going to pick up intensity a little bit.
Yeah.
That note.
Wow. Now we're going to get a call against Holland.
Holland picked up a foul.
Well, they continue at this rate of calling the little touch fouls, there won't be anybody left to play this game.
Yeah,
the same jack wagon that didn't call the hip thrust just called that tiki tack foul.
Everybody better stay at least 3 feet off.
Mason outside. To the freshman, Secret. Secret, one dribble, fires a three straight away, draws nothing but the front of the rim. And Larkin with the rebound. Rochester up one and run.
Starting to see some belief back into the Lady Zebra's eyes.
Malco on the baseline, out to Ruff, quickly to Larkin, who's had a hot hand to X. On around the defense, now to Larkin between the rings. Larkin right side to Ruff, in the corner to Malco. Becky, trouble handling the basketball, gets to Ruff though. Bo back to Becky in the right corner, back to Ruff in the wing. Poe will pull out and reset for Rochester. She mounts past to Larkin. At the volleyball line is Allie Larkin. High on the right side to Malco. 3:10 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 30-29. Three for Holland is good!
Holland hits her third three-pointer of the game.
33-29. Rochester pick it through to the 9-4. Under three to play in the third quarter. Kennedy in the wing. Bounce pass between the rings to Secrets. Back to Kennedy right side. Kennedy for Triton. One dribble. Dump pass to Jennings at the elbow. Outside to Mason. Swings left side to Secrets. Bounce pass to Mason between the rings. Drives it right. Gives to Kennedy. Quick three for Triton. Is good.
A lot of threes tonight.
33-32. Rochester. 2.5 to play in the third. Morgan. Rough with the basketball. Malco. Bounce pass to Holland. X around the defense. Quickly to Ruff. Ruff. Bounce pass to Stasiak. Ruff is good.
Great bounce pass to see hit the court.
And Bo comes up skipping. Rochester by three with 2:15 to play in the third. Secret for Triton. Drives it inside the three-point line. Outside to Kennedy. Kennedy for the Lady Trojans. Back to Secret. Face the three on the wing. Inside the three-point line. Baseline to Hostrasser over the top. The defense to Mason.
Holland probably could have had a shot at that if she wanted to.
Mason right side to Kennedy. Now to Secrets from the elbow. Shot short. Rebound offensively. Put back by Jennings. It's no good. And Rochester comes out of there with a defensive board. Mark runs to our left. Mark and high on the right side. 1:45 to play in the third. Malco in the paint. Kick pass to Larkin. Holland for three. Off the mark. No good. Offensive rebound to Larkin. Out to Holland. X drives it. Throws up a shot. She's fouled the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Good draw by Alexa.
Foul on Kennedy. Her first. 1:33 to play in the third. Rochester by three at 35-32. Alexa Holland will go to the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras. X. First one. Good. Meister and Sellers back into the game. And Hostrasser and Secrets to come out. Bailey Abbott back in for Rochester. Stasiak is out. Next to the line to shoot one more. Second by the junior. Good this time. 36-32 Rochester. Now Lady Zebras to full court press. Sellers gets it in to Kennedy. Over the top, back to Sellers. Sellers move before for the Lady Trojans. Dribble to the floor. No look pass ahead to Meister. Meister around Bailey Abbott. And she has found on the way to the basket. Abbott picked up shot number three.
Yes, did. Caught there. Abbott rushed out on the path by the three-point line.
As she was driving
in. Yeah, Meister was going to the bucket as Abbott was coming out.
Yep.
You're right.
Stasiak back into the game. It'll be Triton basketball baseline right. Sellers looks to get it in. Death to a cutting Mason. Mason shot in the lane. It's going to the foul. Nope, he's going to the foul.
Holland's going to pick that up. That's first, second.
And we weren't joking about on the ticky-tack one.
Yep,
this half.
You're going to have to be careful.
Which such a switch in the game as far as the intensity and the momentum of the first half. Not many fouls called, and now everyone's a little more careful.
Sellers puts it into the corner for Kennedy. She'll fire a three. It's short. Rebound fought for. Holland comes out of the window. Stolen by Sellers. And now Holland is going to pick a pass for three.
Wow.
I thought she tipped it up there.
So Lex's going to really have to watch it. Coach Stasiak's going to get her out of the game.
Then it's 17 to play in the third. Rochester by four. Holland.
We're going to have to find a shooter.
Well, they've got one. It's Allie Larkin.
Yeah, if they can, she can find an opening.
Sellers gets it into Kennedy in the baseline. Kennedy from the elbow, pulled up for good. 36-34. Rochester by two with 70 seconds to play in the third quarter.
Kennedy with her seventh point in this quarter.
Rochester will look to pull air out of the basketball.
Well, Lex is out. I'd say they're running the clock out.
Yeah,
absolutely, yeah.
Malco dribbles in the center circle with 55. Pass to Ruff, and she holds a 52. Morgan holds a 50. Back to Malco in the center circle.
Coach Malco on the bench talking to Alexa Holland, explaining to her how they're calling the fouls in the second half and how she can't be reaching in as the ball's coming up the floor or under the basket.
They have the whistle. We've got to adjust.
Exactly.
Malco right. Holds with no pressure with 32. Becky in the center circle with 30. Triton still in that 3-2 defense, 2-1-2-2 defense. But Becky still holds the 22. Looks to the bench and gets instructions from Coach Stasiak with 20.
Really?
Becky still in the center circle with 18.
Taking a mutual break, I think.
I think that's great.
Yeah.
Malco holds with 13. Looking at Coach Stasiak with a sign to go. Now runs with 10.
Once Larkin comes to the corner.
Left side to Stasiak with 6. Eaton back to Malco with 4. Malco's jumper at the, with 1 is no good. And that'll do it for the third. After 3, Rochester leads 36-34. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball 92.
First Federal Savings Bank is Rochester's only locally owned bank. Stop in today to start a new checking or savings account. Learn more about our online banking options or sign up for Go Green Checking, the checking account that pays you back every time you use your card. Stop in today to see why local banking is better banking. First Federal Savings Bank, serving Rochester and surrounding communities since 1966. Buying your first home? Let the experts at First Federal Savings Bank help you through the process. At First Federal, all of their mortgage loans are serviced locally, with payment options that are convenient for you. Their staff will work with you, answering your questions and providing professional service. First Federal will even pay standard closing costs for qualifying first-time homebuyers. Just another way First Federal takes care of you, your local mortgage lender.
Fourth and final quarter. It's been a good one here at Triton High School. The Lady Zebras leading 36-34, and Rochester will start with the basketball going to our left. Both teams have 4 timeouts left. Holland back on the floor for Rochester. Bailey Abbott is not.
Sellers and Meister for Triton with 3 fouls along with Holland for the Lady Zebras.
Malco in the paint. Rises up. High off the glass. No good. Ball tipped around. Holland comes out of there with it. Wrap around pass up Ruff. Left side to Malco.
Every possession for the rest of the game is going to matter.
Yep, you're right. Larkin looks at a 3, passes it up, dribbles to the middle of the floor. Now to Ruff. Morgan, a couple of dribbles. Triton still in that zone defense. Now to X. Had a hot hand this entire game. Ruff to Holland. 3, left wing. Nope, short. And the rebound to Triton. She almost, it's almost like a no-look three-point shot.
Yep, that's what I was thinking.
She almost looks off the defense just enough to rise up and shoot. It was a good-looking shot. I thought it was going to go, but it was just short. Ball loose. Rochester picks it up.
Oh. And throws it away.
Stasiak throws it off the hand of Triton. It'll go to Rochester.
However, that one works.
A minute gone in the fourth quarter. Rochester by 2. And the Lady Zebras going to our left. Malco through the center circle.
Another possession when they've got the lead. They got to try and stretch this out.
Biggest lead for Rochester has been 4. 3 for Larkin is short. And the rebound to Holland. Stays from going out of bounds right to Larkin.
Great effort by Holland. She just whipped it back in bounds. Luckily, went right to Larkin.
Malco around the defense. Bow. Just past Larkin. Alley. Up pass down low. Tipped away and stolen by Triton. And now Triton and Stasiak are going to be tied up. Meister and Stasiak tied up. And it'll go back to, it'll go to Triton. And now the officials. That's the ball officials. We'll call them together. Talk
never,
about it.
I've never seen that. Calling
Stasiak is going to take Keaton out and bring Abbott in.
Have you seen that before? Where she brings the fouler over to the valley.
Not usually. They usually don't unless something gets said or somebody gives a little shoulder bump or something, then they'll kind of warn them that they're being watched.
2-point lead for Rochester with 6:26 to play in the third quarter. Trying to get away with the travel. Sellers has it. No look pass to Meister. Meister goes to basket hard. She's hit. No call. Ruff with the rebound. Now to Malco.
Abbott did a better job that time not charging out on her while she's driving the basket.
Holland, bounce pass inside to Abbott, outside to Larkin, right side to Ruff. Ruff behind the 3-point line, drives it, kicks it, 3 in the way from Malco. Good!
Back to Malco with her first 3-pointer of the ball game.
And now Rochester by 5 at 39-34. Just under 6 to play in the game. Mason over the top of the defense to Kennedy. Kennedy back to Mason right wing. Meister on the baseline. Over the top of the defense to Sellers. Sellers drive in the paint, pitches up, shot, no good, rebound to Ruff.
Big rebound by Morgan Ruff.
Yeah, it was.
Now to Malco. Rochester runs to our left. Malco on the right side. Now to Ruff. Near side to Hollow, left corner to Larkin. Back to Ruff between the rings.
The thing that those 3-pointers for the Lady Zebras have done besides, you know, give them the lead offensively, it's put a little pressure on
trite offensively, yep. And they're starting to panic a little bit while pushing things that aren't really there.
Malco loses the handle. Tellers picks it up. And now Malco steals it back. Gives it ahead to Larkin. Larkin cross lane pass to Abbott. Layup on the way is good.
Nice job by Abbott with the concentration to make the layup after the contact.
Rochester will take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Ladies Eagle Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Find a play in the basketball game. Rochester up. Their biggest lead of the night is 7 at 41-34. And foul from the Rochester Sentinel just said he heard Cody Stasiak say, all I want are layups.
Well, they're in a full court press. But defensively, they're still going to come with as much pressure as they can put on them.
Jennings down low. Her shot on the way is no good. And Larkin is going to pick up the foul. That's going to send Hannah Jennings to the line to shoot two for Triton. 5 minutes to play in the basketball game. Rochester by 7.
Larkin with her second.
So Jennings, the senior, first one no good.
The layup call doesn't surprise me. My sophomore year here, we were up, and I shot a three, and I made it, and I think I would have been dead if I didn't.
Uh-huh.
So this is familiar territory.
Yeah.
Second one by Jennings, no good, rough with another board. Morgan gives to Holland. Holland quickly pushes to Malco. Becky drives the paint, cut off by the defense, loses the ball, loses the handle, ball loose, ball still loose. And we're going to have a tie-up, and no, Coach Stasiak's going to get a timeout. It'll be a 60. You're listening to Ladies Eagle Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Welcome back to Triton High School, 4:40 to play in the basketball game. Lady Beavers up by 7. Rochester has 2 timeouts left. Triton has 4. Russ around the defense, fouled on the block, and that's going to send Morgan Russ to the line to shoot one of the bonus. Rochester by 7 with 4:35 to play in the game, and the freshman Morgan Russ to the line to shoot one in the bonus.
Jennings picks up her first foul.
And now it comes down to free throw.
Yeah, we haven't done a good job yet this night.
And Triton 6-for-6. You said?
Yeah.
6-6 until the last girl, since her first
game.
No,
you're right.
Yeah. Rough at the line to shoot one of the bonus. First one, the freshman, is off the back of the iron, no good. And the rebound, the Meister. Meister then gives to Sellers. Sellers against Holland, playing with 3 fouls.
She's got a better, smarter job than she just did on that last possession.
Probably could have been whistled for a 4-3.
Kind of,
you're
kind
right.
Of leaning against.
Mm-hmm. But also right, could have
girl.
Been a foul on the other girl for elbow.
Mason misses the shot. Ruff with another rebound. She has 7. And it's going to go to Rochester. Morgan Ruff, I don't think she scored any, but
no. She's
had some big rebounds tonight.
She does have one basket in the second quarter.
Okay.
Yeah, she's done a great job.
I've been impressed with her energy kind of throughout. Just the factor, not like you said, much offense, but just all over on defense.
Rochester breaks the Triton press. Now go around the defense to Larkin. Larkin wrap around pass to Holland High on the right side. Holland to Malco. Rochester by 7, 4 to play in the game. Stasiak to Malco at the volleyball line. Left.
Back door to Alexa right now.
They tried.
And there it is. Holland goes up for the shot. She's fouled the shot. Sugar to the line to shoot 2. Kennedy will pick up the foul. She's lucky that pass got through.
Yeah, I didn't think it was going to make it.
I had it in my mind a little more crisper of a pass, but hey, whatever works then.
Dip on it. She just
a little off.
I'm not sure how Kennedy didn't deflect that.
Yeah, I think it went through her fingers, to be honest.
Holland's free throw short.
Lady Seaver's 3 of 9 right now from the free throw line.
3:50 to play in the game. Rochester by 7. Holland with an opportunity to push this one to 8. X eyes the second one, lets it fly, and this one's good as it rattles in.
I guess the second one. It's just the first one that's been trouble.
4 of 10 from the line.
And I think their goal is to make more than the other team attempts.
Yeah, right.
They're not going on that very well.
Kennedy quickly up the floor for Triton. High on the right side, middle of the floor to Sellers. Quickly left by DeMeister. Meister holds one dribble, top of the key to Mason, who has been quiet this half.
Yeah, she has not scored this half.
Kennedy
Triton has not scored in the fourth quarter.
Against the double team. Gets to Sellers between the circles. Spins away from Ruff. Sellers goes to the basket, throws the shot over Larkin. It's short, and the rebound to Stasiak. Stasiak out to Tom Holland.
What we seem to be finding out is when Triton goes to the basket and we kind of lay off and don't foul, they're expecting the contact, and they're missing.
They have not scored in this fourth quarter. Triton has not.
And how many times have they been close to the bucket and missed?
Holland picks away too fast, gets the mouth with the 3 minutes to play in the game.
I'm not sure. Triton looks like they're almost trying to foul, and they're not getting one called.
Falco out to Larkin. Rochester runs the clock here under three to play in the game. Over the top of the defense to Holland. Back to Larkin here to the timeline. The mouth to Stasiak to Holland. Those are the shot foul and the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. 247 to play in the game. Rochester up 42-34. Holland will go back to the line to shoot two this time for the Lady Beavers, looking to push this lead to 10. And Coach Heckerman will use a timeout. It will be a 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball on 92.1 WROI. .47 to play in the game. Rochester now up by 9. If Holland connects on her first free throw, she'll have one more.
You know, I think Tony might have just called the timeout to give his team a chance to catch their breath.
Well, that's what Coach called by Triton.
Oh, well, thank you.
Okay, well, I think Alexa Holland catching her breath on the bench is a lot easier shooting than free throws.
I think 10
point lead for Rochester. Mason through the defense, throws up a shot. It goes in as a bounce slice in front of the rim.
Wow.
Full court press by Triton.
That's Triton's first bucket in almost 7 minutes.
Ruff to Larkin to Stasiak to Holland. Rochester breaks the press. Holland high on the right side against the double team. Bounce pass to Larkin to the timeline. Back to Holland with 2:25 to play in the game. Down to Malco. Rochester by 8. Late in the game here at Triton High School.
The biggest lead was 10 just a couple minutes ago.
Malco around the defense. Jump stop outside to Larkin in the center circle. Alley drives it with 2 to play in the game. Bounce pass to Stasiak. Keith holds, bounce pass to Malco at the timeline. 2:05 to play in the game. Rochester by 8. Becky, bounce pass to Stasiak. Keaton, one dribble. She's in the center circle. Crossover dribble works at left. Goes to the basket. Goes all the way to the hole. Shuff out the shot. Took her to line to shoot two. Well, when she got post crosser on her hip, she just getting going.
Yep.
Yeah, that's not a bad idea.
This is where jump stops, good crisp passes, and fundamentals are going to be important for the Lady Zebras.
Mason picks up her third.
Keaton with 2. First one for the juniors, good. Rochester back up by 9. Meister and also Seacrest back into the game. Jennings and Ostrosser to sit down.
Well, you know, we talked about the Lady Zebras and how mentally and physically they looked like they were gassed, and we were worried about that coming in.
I think that they're so gassed.
I think Triton is too.
Second by Stasiak, good again.
I think they were probably in the same boat that Rochester was tonight.
37-45.
I got 46.
How come? 37-46. Okay, now we're back to 10. Seacrest drives the baseline. Cut off on the baseline by Stasiak. Kicks it out to Sellers. She loses the basketball. Ball to the floor. We're going to have a tie-up.
Ruff
again in the mix of it.
Always on the floor.
Which is why she wears the D-pad.
Yeah.
Love it. Love it.
Great effort from the freshman tonight.
I've been at 37 to play in the game. Rochester by 10. Sellers, baseline left to trigger in for Triton. Over the top. Triton over the top of the defense. Holland deflects it out of bounds.
Well, nice, you can grab it.
Once Rochester took the lead at 30-29 in the third quarter, it was like a light bulb turned on.
Seacrest, thought about a 15-footer, passes up, gives to Mason. Mason drives the paint, rises up, shot of the lane. Nope, rebound, tipped around. I guess they tipped out of bounds by Larkin with a minute 28 to play in the game. It'll be a tight basketball baseline left. Rochester leads 46-36.
And a lot of shirts under the board for that rebound.
Yep.
Pass tipped around. And Rochester is going to come away with it. Actually, they're going to. Larkin rips it out of the hands of Meister and falls out of bounds.
Fortunately, Ruff had her back turned to the basketball playing defense. Otherwise, the ball would have bounced right into her.
Yep.
Minute 25 to play in the game. Sellers again. Bounce pass to Meister. She's fouled on the shot by Stasiak. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
I don't think Stasiak has many fouls, does she?
That's her second, and that's not a bad foul.
Not to make her miss it. I agree.
Yeah, she's not a good free throw shooter.
Bailey Abbott will come back into the game after the first free throw by Meister with 1:23 to play in the game. Meister's free throw is good. 46-37, Rochester. Bailey Abbott back in. Morgan Ruff will sit down.
Great second half by the freshman.
That girl on a standing ovation.
Yeah.
Didn't score many, but man, did she keep a lot of plays alive.
Yep.
A lot of rebounding and a lot of steals.
Scrappy plays.
Meister second rattles in, and Triton will use another timeout. It is 8:30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
She's looking at her
to play in regulation. Rochester up 46-38. Rochester looking at a full court press. Holland gets the inbound pass. Picks away to the defense. Breaks the press herself. Works high on the left side. Dribbles to Bailey Abbott. Bounce pass to Malcolm near the timeline. Becky Malcolm back to Holland. Next around the defense. Picks away through traffic. Now dribbles to the top of the key. Being chased by Mason. Holland.
And we're not getting to reach in tic-tac fouls now here late in the game.
Holland. Picks up the dribble.
They're wanting a foul and they're not getting it.
Under a minute to play in the game. Nacho through the defense. Outside the mark of the 53.
Both coaches screwed the fouls.
Larkin down past the Fasiak. Keaton then is fouled by Sellers.
I think these guys just want to go home. They weren't to blow the whistle.
But the scary part about that is that Triton's trying to foul and they're not getting the ticket back on the ball. That's when someone's going to intentionally foul, and that's not good.
Yeah.
48 seconds to play in the game. Rochester by 8. Keaton Stasiak. At the line for two free throws for Rochester.
That burns off a lot of time.
Yeah, that helps
almost
play.
A minute, yeah.
Keaton's first one, good. Rochester's biggest lead has been in tonight. Keaton has an opportunity to push the Lady Zebras back to that with 48 seconds to play in the game. Stasiak's second one, short, rebound to strike. 9-point lead for the Lady Zebras. 45 seconds to play in the game. Sellers around Holland. Right side to Kennedy. Kennedy drives the baseline. Pull up 10 footers. Good. 35 seconds. Rochester by 7. Larkin gets it into Stasiak. She is fouled by Sellers. And Keaton will go back to the line to shoot 2 with 32 seconds to play in the game. With Rochester up by 7.
Is that her last foul?
Yeah.
So Coach Heckerman will have to go back to his bench.
She'll finish with 7 points.
Grabbing a girl off the bench. Got a shooting shirt on.
Shayla May, a junior, will come in for Triton. 32 seconds to play in the game. Rochester by 7. Stasiak at the line to shoot 2. Brad Thomas, Abby Malco, and David Musselman.
Stasiak 3 of 4 in this fourth quarter from the line.
First one, he is good. Got one more. Boy, it's almost like they flipped the switch. You can see that they were struggling bad with energy. And
once they took the lead, they're midway through the third quarter. It's like, bang.
Boost the momentum.
Yep.
Second for Keaton's good again. 49-40. Rochester on top of 30. Mason drives with 29. Dribbles to the near side. Gives to Kennedy with 25.
Pass at her face.
Over the top of the defense to May. To Seacrest for 3. Left wing is off the back of the iron. No good. Malco with a rebound and a foul coming on Mason. That's going to send Becky Malco to the line. We're 2 with 18 seconds to play with the Lady Zebras up by 9.
Mason picks up her third, her fourth, I'm sorry.
And Morgan Ruff will come in for probably Holland. And Garrison will come in as well. 18 seconds to play. Rochester by 9. And Becky Malco at the line to shoot 2. And Odell will come in after the first free throw as well. First one for Malco is good. So Odell, Garrison, and Ruff in. Stasiak, Larkin, and Abbott out.
Larkin's going to finish with 12 points on 4 three-pointers tonight.
Big three-pointers.
Big three-pointers.
That
kept Rochester in this game the first three quarters.
Yep.
Second one by Becky's good again. Timeout, Rochester. 51-40. Rochester up with 18 seconds of play. It's a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Substitutions for Rochester, also number 14, Grace Piper, and number 44, Kennedy Musselman.
Seconds to play in the game. Rochester up 51-40. Coach Stasiak pulled all the starters. Grace Piper and Kennedy Musselman comes into the varsity game. 51 seconds to play in the game.
18 seconds.
What'd I say?
51.
18 seconds to play in the game.
I'm like, wait.
That's why you got a headset on tonight.
Yes, yeah. I know.
So Brad wouldn't have caught that.
I wasn't. I was adding up scores.
Mason Grimes with 15. Works against Ruff with 14. Mason step back three with 13. No good. Offensive rebound. Kicks it out to Mason with 9. Long three over Piper. Nope. Air ball goes out of bounds with 5.9 to play in the game. Rochester going to get it back. Up by 11. And Ruff going to get it to Piper.
Yep.
Rochester going to move their record to 11-0 by defeating the number 6 team in the state, Class 1A, the Christ Lady Trojans. 51-40. You're listening to Ladies Hear Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Are you tired of your internet speed slowing you down? Not a problem. Get connected at the speed of light over RTC's advanced fiber optic network. Work, surf, or play on the net faster than ever before. Choose from multiple residential or business packages with speeds so fast it'll have you flying away. Already have RTC's Fiber Connect internet? Upgrade your package today. RTC. Local services, local support, and local investments.
We don't have that channel, Ma.
What channel is the Science Channel on?
We don't have that channel either, Ma.
How about the Hallmark Movie Channel?
Ma, we don't have any of those channels.
Well, why not?
Because we don't have digital tier.
So we don't have any of the digital tier channels?
Why do you think I'm always playing video games, Ma?
Because you